spin and pop come together in the controllable Volkl V-Sense 10 Tour. Intermediate and advanced players looking for a maneuverable player's racquet with outstanding feel and control will want to take a look at this precise 98 square inch racquet. Based on the racquet Nicolas Almagro endorses on tour, this option offers a user-friendly spec and has been constructed with Volkl's precise power beam, making it slightly less angular and adding a classic feel. First up, we have Hannah. Now, how did this racquet pair with your aggressive baseliner game?
I really liked this racquet. I played well with it. It was right in my spec range. I could take full swings from the baseline, so I just found it a lot more control-oriented, which is different from what I usually prefer, but it was still nice to play with. The sweet spot was really plush, and I could really get into a rhythm from the baseline. Now, I did lose power out, stretch out wide with this racquet, and I also found outside of the sweet spot to be unforgiving, which was a little bit disappointing. On volleys, I lost a lot of put-away power and didn't have the stability that I wanted, so I think I would maybe mess around with adding some weight to this, even though I usually don't do that. But overall, I would just recommend this racquet for someone that's looking for that more control-oriented frame.
Next up, we have Troy. Now, I know this is the V-Sense 10 Tour, but we both felt it was a little light for a tour racquet, and I know you customized it. How did it work out?
Yeah, much like the Wilson Ultra Tour that we just finished playtesting, a little bit lightweight for being considered a tour racquet. But with that being said, when I found the sweet spot on this racquet, especially from the baseline, it just felt really dialed in. I love the precision, I love the control. I was getting great control and good blend of spin potential from the 16-19 pattern. So swinging out, I really felt like I could place the ball wherever I wanted to. But talking about the weight, me and Chris were talking. We got to hit a prototype of Almagro specs with this racquet a few months back, and that one was almost a perfect racquet for me. So I was a little upset that they dropped the weight on it, but with some customization, plays like a great player frame compared to some of the previous Volkls. It's got a little crisper, firmer feel, kind of like my 6195. So with the weight added to it, it plays like a really nice player frame.
Next up, we have Chris. Now, I know your racket of choice is a little stiffer, more powerful, but you have a soft spot for the classic rackets. How did this work out?
I really like the feel of this racket. I like the blend of a really good feeling, comfortable, plush feeling frame with a nice lively open string pattern. Put a poly in here and I'm really dialed in. Easy access to spin. I really enjoyed coming through off the ground in its stock weight. It's a really fast feeling racket, so I was able to get some nice snap on my serves and good access to pace and spin off the ground. But like Troy, I did hit the Almagro spec version and I love that racket. Add some weight to this one, you can get there pretty easily. And so this is a racket I would definitely customize. Do the usual, you know, leather grip, a little bit of weight in the hoop, and it would be even more dialed in for me. But stock, I thought it had good maneuverability. It could do with a little bit more stability at net. That was probably my only knock, but really good access to spin, good access to pace for a player's racket. So fun play test for me.
I was also on this play test, and I have to agree with the other three play testers that this was going to be a great racket for customization and adding some weight. From the baseline, I found it to be really powerful, and the open string pattern was launching balls out, so I really had to adjust my swing and just pull in that extra spin to keep the balls in the baseline. I found the upper hoop to play a slightly erratic, but nothing that a little bit of weight here and there couldn't fix. Now at net, I found it to be a bit unstable, but I was playtesting it right next to the most stable racket out there, which is the RF97. And then on serve, I found it to be really fast, and it almost swung too fast for me at times. So again, that extra weight would come in handy for sure. Overall, I really liked how fast and maneuverable this racket was, and I think it's a great platform for customization. We play-tested this racket strung with Volkl Cyclone at 54 pounds. And if you want to learn more about this racket and how to customize it, be sure to head to tenniswarehouse.com or check it out on one of our affiliate sites.